Hi, I'm Veronica Vance. Coming up, we head downtown for some scrumptious surf and turf. Pop on over to Cobo to get tips on planning your next family reunion. And then we have a ton of fun at Dave & Buster's, so stick around.
Production funding for this program was made possible by the Detroit Metro Convention and Visitors Bureau, driving tourism growth in Metro Detroit since 1896. More information is available at visitdetroit.com.
The D has all kinds of great restaurants, but today we are downtown and we're doing a little spin on the classic surf and turf. Up first, Rub Barbecue on West Adams.
Hi, my name is Randy Yona, owner of Rub Barbecue Pub in Detroit. Just a great tip from Rub Barbecue Detroit. We do currently have valet parking for all your game day needs.
So Randy, what's the significance of the saddles here?
The saddle brings to Detroit our good old down south barbecue.
Which is what you guys do here,
Rub Barbecue. Correct, that's what we do best. We bring down south right into Detroit.
And so what are some of your most popular menu items?
Most popular, if you're talking appetizers, burnt ends, by the end of the day we're completely out.
Yeah, so they're awesome.
They're awesome, they're phenomenal. Beef brisket, pulled pork, and of course our famous ribs that we're known for.
So Randy, tell me a little about the place, kind of a rustic decor, I love it.
What we did here, we brought in a little rustic but yet modern look.
Mm-hmm.
We kept a lot of Detroit stuff, the original stuff that was here.
So they've got a whole smorgasbord of food off your menu here.
It looks like some good stuff we're eating over here.
Yeah.
Over here we got the bases loaded, beef brisket, our famous andouille sausage, side of beans and coleslaw. Here we have a sandwich, which is a Harwell with sweet potato fries.
So the Harwell sandwich is after, of course.
Good old Ernie.
Good old Ernie.
If you see on our menu, go to rubbbbqdetroit.com. Mm-hmm. All our sandwiches are named after popular Detroit natives. All our meats we buy locally, Eastern Market. We try to keep all our business on a local level.
So what to affect the flavor? Is that sort of one of your secret ingredients?
It is one of our secret ingredients, but I'll give you this. We do use cherry, apple, and hickory, depending on what we're smoking.
Oh,
yeah.
Give it a
brings out the flavor.
So it's a pretty long bar you've got here.
Well, there's a little history behind this bar. Years ago, this building was known as the Brass Rail, which was known to have the longest bar in Detroit. So we decided, hey, let's go ahead and replicate it and bring the longest bar back. Also, we brought 30 taps of beer, which is pretty much unheard of, which is probably the most amount of taps in the whole city of Detroit.
So for barbecue, you gotta have sauce, and these are Rub sauces?
These are six of Rub's homemade sauces that are made in-house, all from the finest ingredients and spices. We've got Memphis, which is a sweet sauce.
Mm-hmm.
In Detroit, you get a little bit of kick of sweets, spicy. KC is more of a ketchup base, as you know. Apple, your good old apple. We cut fresh apples, put in the sauce.
Cool.
Carolina, mustard base. Texas, one's got a little heat to it.
That one, so Texas is the hot one, and Detroit is sweet and spicy like me.
Correct, there you go.
Okay, now on to the good stuff.
Alrighty, let's talk.
Okay, so this is
this rums. Right here is our full slab of St. Louis ribs. Everything we do here is dry rubbed with a side of sweet potato mash, our famous greens, southern style greens, which we make in-house, and our baked beans. Ribs get smoked in the smoker for about 5 to 6 hours.
Oh, okay.
Yes. This right here we have is a beef brisket,
which
is smoked in a smoker anywhere from 14 to 16 hours.
The pink right here, that's how you know that it's authentically smoked.
And then we have the pulled pork over here, which we smoke anywhere from 12 to 14 hours.
And then the burnt ends.
Burnt ends, which is our most.
So I'm not crazy in liking the burn pieces.
No, dig in.
Okay.
Nice and tender.
Oh, that is fabulous.
Yep.
You want to try some? Mm. All mine.
Usually brisket, it's hard to tear apart.
Oh, that wasn't at all.
No.
You just saw I sliced
very
that like
tender.
Butter. That's super tender.
And then, of course, our Detroit sauce is our most popular.
Detroit.
And pretty much it settles with everything.
Settles with everything. I'm going to try a little bit of that on the pork. So again, the pink part, not undercooked, it just means authentically smoked.
Smoked.
Oh, I like it. Really good. Yes. I'm gonna dig in.
That's how we know a real barbecue person.
Mmm. Oh, these are tender and juicy.
Very
too.
Tender and juicy.
Delicious.
All our meats. We delicious. Look butcher at that. Everything in house here.
So now we know Rub Barbecue Pub in Detroit for awesome finger looking good barbecue. And now for the surf part of our turf, we're going to enjoy a little seafood at Tom's Oyster Bar on Jefferson, right across from the Renton.
Hi, I'm Chris Verzi, your host at Tom's Oyster Bar Detroit. We're your place in the D where you can get served. Here's a tip. On game night, park here and take our shuttle to the game. On non-event night, park here for $5 or after 6 for free anywhere on the street.
Also, Chris, I'm greeted by a wonderful seafood smell when I come in here.
That's right.
And almost reminiscent of like a New England type feel of decor.
And that's right. And I think that's what we had been going for when we opened back in 2000. This is a place that I think is sophisticated enough to get a fantastic meal at a reasonable price, but you don't have to come in a suit and tie or a dress. You know, come as you are.
And then you've got a great wraparound bar. You can get food here, drinks, just come relax.
Absolutely. Everything from sushi, seafood, the grill. We've even got snacks and appetizers. It's a varied menu here in the D, but it's a great place to come for surf. As you'll see, we do a lot of different things on our menu for our lunch, for our dinner. You can get an awesome turkey sandwich, a turkey wrap. You can get wonderful salads here, in addition to all the seafood.
And so you can either dine down here, or you can go upstairs.
That's right, during the season.
So another reason to come here, the fabulous view up here.
Just look at this view, like you said.
So you can eat up here, you get a full bar, you put tables out or dining,
we're gonna have
what do you do, the whole
exactly.
kit and caboodle?
We have a full kitchen here, a full bar, restrooms for everybody. The deck is a wonderful place for you to come, have a great view, have a great meal, and see our city.
And the people mover comes right along here.
Jump up.
Hey, at home in the D. Could it be more perfect?
I don't think so, yes.
I live in the area, downtown Detroit, and I love the seafood here. Come here frequently. Detroit is moving up, and I'm happy that Tom's Oyster Bar is a part of this.
Here are the oysters.
Wow, now, so how many oysters are you going to go through in a day?
I couldn't even tell you the exact number of oysters we're going to go through, but it's a lot. We have several bins that are full of anywhere between 75 to 150 oysters, depending on their size, and we'll go through all of them in generally 1 to 2 days' time.
Wow.
This is James, an expert shucker, by the way.
I was going to say, he made that look so easy. It looked like you just popped it open, gave it a little twist, and there you go.
That's exactly it. I like the northern ones. They're a little plumper, a little saltier. Southern ones, a little gentler, not as much salt. Now, James, do you eat oysters?
No.
James doesn't eat them.
No.
See, I will. Now, we have you guys here. Do you want to try one, Mick? Are you brave? You can go with the hot sauce. You definitely go with the lemon. You can go with the horseradish cocktail sauce here. I like that the best. I'm okay with hot sauce, but I find it destroys the flavor. Just a dab will do you, to be honest. And this is really, really delicious. Now, you don't have to do this, and some purists don't. So, ready?
Purists don't, but
to the D.
Yes, to the D.
Here we go. Okay. That's delicious. Almost shrimpy in a way, aren't they? Nothing to be
you
afraid of.
You turned me around. Oh, it's, wow.
James?
No. That was, no, James, really. It's delicious.
So come here. So some of the things that we're really proud of here at Tom's Oyster Bar is we're getting everything here from Eastern Market. Our fresh herbs, our vegetables, our eggplant to make our eggplant parmesan. Look at that. It's not quite ready to go yet, but where else can you get that here in the D? And lime juice to make our own key lime pie, which we make right here. I have my New York strip steaks. We have veal. We don't do barbecue here. That's better left for some places. But we do grill a steak, and we grill a darn good one.
Well, Chris, I love this little behind the scenes point of view.
Ramsey is making our blue cheese encrusted New York strip steak as we speak. He works so much in the kitchen. Those are actually burn marks. Those are not
tattooed.
That's not tattooed. Your mom would be happy with a Tom's Oyster Bar too, because we're using fresh vegetables and we're not cooking them to death.
This is not a commercial.
I know exactly.
Okay, Chris, ooh la la, these are some of your famous appetizers here.
Famous appetizers, and they actually, some of them eat like a meal, to be honest, Veronica. So here we have.
Really?
Yeah.
This is enough food for a meal.
I think so, because this is, not if you're me, but hey. This is our cold plate appetizer, mm-hmm. and this really is one of those. This is surf. You definitely get down in the day here.
Yeah.
I mean, it has a range of salmon and pâtés and smoked mackerel and peppered mackerel and a
Northern Michigan whitefish sausage.
These are another oyster sampler here. We have some of the blue points that we had. We had some James River.
And then
this is my personal favorite. It's our peel and eat shrimp. Okay. And what we do with these is when we prepare them, instead of just boiling them in water, blanching them, we actually boil them in a dark beer. They have a slight bitterness from the beer, but that beautiful shrimpy flavor. And really, again, more surf in the deep.
Fish sausage.
Absolutely.
Yeah. It doesn't have a heavy, greasy taste like a lot of sausage. Mm-hmm. It's a light taste. It must be the fish in it that does that.
I would imagine so, yes.
I'm going to eat the other bite, too. No, beer shrimp. Mm-hmm. So no plate, no lemon or anything. Just
nothing.
Au
naturel. Mm-hmm. So we're really proud of that.
Very good.
And again, what it is, it's a very delicate, trippy flavor.
It is. It's very nice.
Mm-hmm. And then here's our salmon pate. Mm.
No, I love salmon.
Okay.
More of a bold flavor.
A very
but
bold.
Still oh my goodness, that's delicious.
Yeah, isn't it?
Now I can eat that for breakfast and dessert.
Absolutely.
That is delicious. Oh, I think that's my favorite thing. So there you go, our version of Surf and Turf in the D. We've got our fabulous barbecue at Rub Barbecue over on West Adams, and of course our surf at Tom's Oyster Bar in Jefferson, which as you pointed out also has some turf in it.
It does.
So.
Anyway, hope to see you guys down here.
Yeah.
Right? Cheers.
Cheers.
Gem that happens every year in Detroit. It's a free family reunion planning seminar, and this great community event gives you all kinds of wonderful information to help you plan your reunion, and it happens twice a year, every year at Cobo. Family reunion is a big deal in Detroit. What do we got going on here today?
Today we have our free family reunion planning seminar. It's an event that we do twice a year. It's usually at the end of September or beginning of October in the fall. Mm-hmm. And in the spring, it's usually at the end of March or the beginning of April.
Yeah. Well, one key thing that you mentioned is that it's free.
You come here, all you have to do is pre-register. Mm-hmm. And you can do that by calling our hotline at the Convention and Visitors Bureau. And it's free for you and another family member to come and listen to things like how do I plan my family reunion, trying to work with local vendors. We'll give you tips and hints on how to do that, and it's all free.
At Cobo, it's always in Cobo.
It's always at Cobo. It's one of the only venues that's large enough to host this awesome event, so.
Where the registration happens, and then you're giving out information as well.
Absolutely. When you register, you get a bag. Mm-hmm. Inside the bag is a outline of the presentations that you're going to hear. So it's a take-home piece. So even if you're here and you're listening and you can't really remember what was presented, you've got a hard copy of the presentation to go back to for reference. Mm-hmm. We also have a list of all of our exhibitors that's in the bag, so always use that as a reference piece as well. Mm-hmm. And we also have some different things like a pencil and Detroit folders
Fun
and some
stuff.
Detroit memorabilia that you can take back also. And actually, this is a twofold purpose. We keep tabs on you the whole entire way throughout your planning process, and in the end, we give everybody coming to your family reunion from out of town and locals a bag, a pencil, postcards, different things so you can use that for your reunion.
Cindy Ingram from the Williams family reunion arrives. LaShawn Tellis with the Whitfield family reunion.
So what other things do you do to make the event fun?
Well, one thing that really gets the crowd going is that we give prizes periodically throughout the seminar to keep people aware of what's going on and to win some fun things. We give away water bottles, planners, bags, all sorts of things that a family reunion planner can use.
Regina Lockridge from the Lockridge Family Reunion, which I have to say on her form it says she is the number one Veronica Vans fan.
And you're providing food.
Food, yeah.
Free breakfast on
free
top
breakfast.
Of everything.
Yeah. Wow. We give away a continental breakfast, so you can come in, have a light breakfast in the morning, listen to what we have to say, and then afterward also win some exciting prizes in our trade show that we offer after the education.
And you're going to have a prize board for that?
We do. We have a prize board, and all of our vendors donate prizes, things like overnight hotel stays, tickets to attractions, mm-hmm. tickets to different events and things going on around town are all up for grabs if you come to the seminar.
We actually work with over 800 partners, and those partners consist of hotels in Metro Detroit, restaurants, transportation companies, tour companies, t-shirt companies, catering companies, and the list goes on. Whatever it is you're looking for, please check that box off.
The parking fees, is that something that the hotels usually negotiate?
Usually not. I'm going to say 9.5 times out of 10, mainly because most hotels have an outside company.
So the event continues with a trade show, a full-out trade show.
Absolutely. You're able to come actually visit some of those places and services that would help you with your family reunion.
See, I think I'm going to take a peek around.
Take a stroll. It's exciting. You might even pick up some goodies along the way.
Well, thank you, Jennifer.
Thank you, Veronica.
Family reunions have a great time on board. A lot of them really enjoy coming out for a Motown cruise. It's a great way to showcase Detroit's history for all your out-of-town relatives. We work with the person planning. We try and make it as easy as possible for the organizer.
Well, the great thing that we have available is a website that is actually set up for our family reunion. So they can go right to the website to purchase different items such as shirts, balloons, and it really makes it... Yeah,
they're a big thing, aren't they?
T-shirts are huge. Yes.
What we do is historic tours of the city and share them with them so the family reunions could know what a rich history Detroit has.
We offer discounted family reunion rates. We have discounted family reunion catering menus. We do have our own on-site catering, so we have banquet facilities available for family reunions to organize a dinner dance.
How valuable did you guys find the seminar today?
It was truly valuable. There were things that we learned aware of. We
That's
was able
true.
To get some new ideas.
So you've had a good time. You won something off the prize board.
I actually won something. I'm very pleased. First time here. A lot of information. I think anyone that's doing anything with family need to come here. It's great. I would tell all my family members about it.
One-stop shopping, because that could be a lot of work trying to call all these places and trying to see what's happening.
Actually, one of the great things about it is networking with other reunion planners so that you learn things that even though it's not presented at the seminar, other people are planning, so we get ideas from them too.
I had no idea that planning a family reunion was so involved. I mean, it's like planning a wedding. So if you need tips or suggestions, remember, this event is held twice a year at Cobo. There are plenty of things to see and do in Metro Detroit this month, and our calendar of events is up next to point you in the right direction.
Spreading It Around is a comedy about riches, and the Spring Boat Expo sails into Novi. The Mythbusters demonstrate their mind-twisting experiments, and Championship College Hockey faces off in the D. Living Stations provides an epic theatrical experience, and Smokey Robinson presents Human Nature, the Motown Show. To learn of any changes, log on to visitdetroit.com or call 1-800-DETROIT.
If you're looking for a place that's out of the ordinary to host your next function or even just to grab a bite to eat, then you really should check out Dave & Buster's in Utica. It's like family game night to the 100th degree. Well, so Chris, tell me a little bit about Dave & Buster's. Is it a restaurant? Is it a bar? A game? What is it?
Dave & Buster's, I mean, really is probably a family entertainment complex when you think about it. We're 56,000 square feet. We have two full-service bars. We have private rooms for special events. We have a million-dollar midway, games for all ages, kids and adults, billiard tables, hand shuffleboard tables, dining menu that goes from steaks to pastas to chicken dishes to appetizers.
Is this like one of the dining rooms then? Or
this is the main dining room.
Main
we call
room.
This our grand dining room.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have other areas throughout the building that can be rented out for private parties. And then we also have dining back in the midway.
So maybe we can come back and eat, but in the meantime, can we go tour the place?
Absolutely, let's go.
Okay.
Right now, this is a private party. They're doing a special event. We do a lot of these. This is one of the things that I don't think a lot of people know about Dave & Buster's. Mm-hmm. We do a lot of private parties. They can book birthday parties, corporate events, you name it, wedding rehearsals, wedding dinners, the whole bit.
What a fun place to do it in, too. Okay, this is so neat for a kid's birthday party. I love this marquee.
This is our very special guest, Marcus. He's having his 10th birthday party here today with us.
How neat.
Where's Marcus?
He's the birthday boy. What a fun place to have a birthday party. Cool. So how many people does this room hold?
This room will hold about 50 guests.
What a good, nice, intimate room close to the game.
You still have your private buffet service. You have your own sound system and TV system.
You know, what's this grandiose entrance, the showroom?
This is what we call our showroom. It's a private area with its own bar, hand-carved wood.
Oh my God, and it's gorgeous.
This room will hold up to about 150 guests.
150, and you've got, what is that, a stage up there?
We have a stage. There is a large theater screen there as well. They can do business presentations in here. You can have DJs come in. Productions, we do mystery dinner theater here as well.
The Midway, this is where all the action's taking place, right?
This is our $1 million Midway.
Wow.
Absolutely. This makes up roughly one third of our building. There's games for everybody back here. There's games for small children, there's games for older kids, there's games for serious gamers as well.
And so for the corporate meetings that you were talking about, those adults, they're coming back here. I'm sure they're having a blast.
They're coming back here, they're playing games like Daytona, NASCAR, they're doing their team building events.
So there's not just gaming, we got a bar?
Full service bar back here, we got the TVs, menus the same throughout the building.
Okay.
And then you have all your games back here as well.
So how many different games do you
have? We have over 200 different games.
Oh, wow, that's a lot. All right, here we go. 500. Well, that worked up quite an appetite, and my thirsty, so we go grab
a bite. Let's go up to the Viewpoint Bar, get something to eat, and a nice cold beverage up top.
Sounds good.
All right.
So next to the gorgeous bar, you've got more gaming.
First class billiard tables. We have 12 first class billiard tables in the restaurant, along with one snooker table as well.
Well, you forget to even have all that gaming going on when you sit here. It's like you're in a nice upscale restaurant.
It's totally different atmosphere.
Gorgeous. Absolutely. Out here. Now we've got, these are some of your signature dishes here, right?
These are some of our most popular items. We have our teriyaki sirloin. Mm-hmm. We also have our bar wing combo, mini cheeseburgers on Hawaiian rolls with our buffalo wings and fries, mm-hmm. and our barbecue chicken and ribs.
So dip it in a little bit of the sauce here. Ooh, that's very good. Wow. Food is just as good as the atmosphere. Kind of a twist on the loaded baked potato, loaded mashed potato. Yummy, I love the green onions on top. Very good. Those are tasty. This is a Hawaiian roll?
Hawaiian roll.
So we've got here, these are your signature wings?
Signature wings.
Oh, nice kick to the sauce.
Chicken and ribs. Can't go wrong. Mm-hmm.
That's good too. Cheers.
Cheers.
Perfectly good. Not too dry. They're good. Very good. Perfect. Oh, well, you fed me well, Chris, but I'm going to take some of this energy, go back out on the Midway and check out some of the games.
That sounds fantastic.
All right. Well, thank you so much for showing me around.
Thank you.
Had a great time. All right. I'm heading out back to the Midway. Wish me luck for 2 points. Here we go. Woo! Good luck! We've got two sisters here competing against each other. They're in a dance-off competition. If you'll notice here, Dad's in the machine and Son is outside watching Dad have fun. finished playing, you come over to the winner circle to redeem your tickets. You trade it in for a prize, and it's actually like a full-fledged store inside. They've got prizes for young kids all the way on up to adult prizes. From food to drinks to games to family fun, Dave & Buster's in Utica has adrenaline-pumping action and fun for everyone. And we're off! That's our show. Thanks for watching. I'm Veronica Vance. And remember, if you'd like more information on any of the places we visited, log on to visitdetroit.com. So until I see you next time, go out and explore on your own and discover the D.
To learn about discounts and special offers for featured attractions, plus how to get copies of Visit Detroit magazine, click on visitdetroit.com.
Production funding for this program was made possible by the Detroit Metro Convention and Visitors Bureau, driving tourism growth in Metro Detroit since 1896. More information is available at visitdetroit.com.